What's the difference between Google Docs and Microsoft Office 365? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Next to email and content consumption like YouTube or social media, word processors, spreadsheets, and other applications may be the most common ways we use our computers. We might call them business apps, but they serve a wide variety of roles ranging from personal to corporate. Microsoft Office has long been an industry standard, but Google Docs is an equally compelling and very popular toolset. First, though, we need to talk about names. Very technically, Google Docs refers to the Google Word Processing application called Docs. That means Google Docs would compare to only Microsoft Word. In practice, however, most people say Google Docs to refer to the full suite of applications available, which is the way I'm going to be using the term. I'll compare it to Microsoft 365 suite counterparts. Speaking of Microsoft 365, it's gone by several names over the years. Microsoft Office is the original name of the productivity suite that included Word, Excel, and more. It's probably the term we're all most familiar with. When its subscription model was introduced, the name got changed to Office 365. The name changed again, for reasons unclear to me anyway, to Microsoft 365. And the current official name is Microsoft 365 Copilot, which of course reflects Microsoft's desire to cram AI, Copilot in this case, into anything and everything they can. Now, aside from the typical version-to-version differences, they're all the same and they all refer to the Microsoft suite of productivity applications that include Word and Excel and more. Okay, with all that naming stuff out of the way, let's have a quick look at what some of these are. Google Docs. I have Google Docs here up on my screen. And like I said, it's focused primarily on word processor. That's where we ended up with, right? These are all opportunities to create new documents, new word processing documents. If we click on the hamburger menu here in the upper left, you'll see that we've got all of the applications that are available. Google even calls this whole thing Google Docs, even though there's Docs within Google Docs, hence the confusion. But it includes a word processor, Docs, a spreadsheet called Sheets, Slides, which are essentially PowerPoint, Forms, which is basically a data entry package, and, of course, Google Drive itself, which is the storage mechanism behind it. It is cloud-based. All of the files you use in Google Docs are stored in your Google Drive. It is free with a Google account, and it runs completely within your browser. There's nothing to install. All right, Microsoft 365 you'll find at office.com or a few other places that they might end up redirecting you to. It includes a word processor. If we hit the waffle icon over here in the upper left, then you'll see that we've got all the icons for all the Microsoft 365 apps. It includes a word processor, a spreadsheet, the presentation software, PowerPoint, data collection, note-taking, and a bunch more, including, of course, Outlook.com email and OneDrive.com online storage. The way we think of Microsoft 365 is that it is software you install on your PC, though there are free online-only versions of some of the tools available. It requires an annual paid subscription, and it stores files on your PC, in OneDrive cloud storage, or both. Okay, here are some of the most notable differences between the two. The platform. Google Docs is web-based only, period. Microsoft 365 is primarily a desktop application. But there are, like I said, free versions of some of the applications available on the web. Offline. You can use Google Docs offline in a limited fashion if you have an appropriate browser extension. Since it's running in the browser, it actually requires support from the browser to do things offline. But it's really focused on doing things online. It kind of assumes you're connected. Microsoft 365, on the other hand, well, it's a fully featured desktop application. It works on files that you've got stored on your PC. So offline is just not a problem. Storage, again, Google Docs is all about Google Drive. That's where your files are kept. Microsoft 365, well, even though Microsoft is pushing you to store things in OneDrive, you're absolutely capable of having your files on your PC and only your PC if you want to. Now, one place where they actually do differ a little bit is in what I would consider to be collaboration. Google Docs, because it is 100% online at all times, it actually makes real-time collaboration possible. Easy, even. Because if you've shared your document with another person and they start editing it and you start editing at the same time, you can both kind of sort of see your edits happen on the screen as you both type. This is actually one of the things that I and Gary do when we do the TEH podcast. We have a shared document in a Google Doc that is our notes for the show, and we're basically revising them in real time as we go through the show. Microsoft 365 can do the same thing. It's real-time sharing using OneDrive if you've got your files stored in OneDrive. Obviously, if the files are stored locally, then collaboration really isn't a thing. But if you've got them online in OneDrive, then indeed collaboration can happen. A good example is that my publication schedule is stored in OneDrive. And the people that work on it at the same time all can edit that same file in one place. And while it's not quite as real time as Google Docs, we can in fact see where the other person is, what they've got selected, their most recent changes, and so forth, in more or less real time. Cost, of course, is one of the big things. Google Docs is completely free. Of course, there are upgrades available, but what we're talking about here today is essentially 100% free. The only thing you might need to pay more for is if you needed more storage. Microsoft 365, yes, the desktop applications are a subscription model. The free web versions, well, yeah, they're free. Now, features, this is a difficult one to really compare because a lot of the features really boil down to what do you care about? Google Docs, classify it as, yeah, it's got a basic to moderate feature set. It's plenty for most people. On the other hand, Microsoft Office, almost by definition, is the standard. It's the full-featured standard of all the features you can consider in Word and Excel and all of the other applications that are part of it. In terms of compatibility, while you can exchange documents between the two systems, you retain the highest fidelity. You come up with the fewest surprises if you stay within each service's ecosystem. So Google Docs are most compatible with Google Docs and other users of Google Docs. Microsoft 365, yeah, you're most compatible across Microsoft 365 applications. Again, you can exchange them, but there's almost always a surprise. Now, in general, Google Docs has fewer features, but even so, the feature set is rich enough that you may not miss a thing. Microsoft 365 is, in some ways, the gold standard. It includes an extensive set of features and tools. It's perfect for power users and business settings and has become, in a sense, an industry standard across the corporate and the educational world. When it comes to collaboration and sharing, the differences become more apparent. Since Google Docs is web native, it's well optimized for real-time collaboration and sharing. Multiple users can edit the same document at the same time. Users can see each other's edits as they are made, even seeing the carrot and selection movement being made by others. Since documents are stored in Google Drive online, sharing is easily handled just by creating links to the online document with the appropriate view and/or edit permissions set up as desired. Microsoft 365 also supports real-time collaboration and sharing, but only if the documents are stored in OneDrive online. The older default behavior of storing and working on documents stored only on your PC does not allow for that. Microsoft file formats like Word's .docx and Excel's .xlsx and others have themselves also become industry standard in many business uses. They are perhaps the most commonly exchanged file formats, regardless of the tools actually being used. Now, Google Docs will save in its own format, but it can export to Microsoft 365 formats. It's important to realize that Google documents are never saved on your computer, even in Google Drive, which saves, as it turns out, only a shortcut to the file that is still online. To actually save a document on your computer, you have to export it from Google Docs. Like many Microsoft 365 alternatives, exporting in Microsoft file formats does not guarantee complete compatibility. The exchange is relatively easy since both will read and write both Microsoft and the Open Document format that Google uses. However, when exchanging a file between Microsoft 365 and Google Docs users, there are usually differences in layout and formatting. The severity of those differences varies depending on the complexity of the document that's involved. Now, both platforms offer mobile apps for your phone or tablet. Google Docs, of course, works best in the Google Android ecosystem, though it's available on iOS as well. Microsoft apps are also available on both Android and iPhone. You'll find the apps in their respective platform app stores, and in both cases, it's easier to start at the cloud storage app, Google Drive or OneDrive respectively, and then open your documents from there. And as always, features will vary between your free and your paid accounts. Google Docs, being a web-only tool, works on almost any browser on almost any operating system. That means Google Docs is available on Windows and Mac and Linux and probably other things. All you need to do is fire up your web browser and visit the site. The same is true for the free version of Microsoft 365 apps. Since they are also web-only, they should work well from any of those platforms. I say should because Microsoft, of course, prioritizes Windows and its Edge browser. The downloadable and installable apps for Microsoft 365 are available for Windows and for macOS. There are no Linux versions. Now, as I mentioned above, Google Documents exist only in the cloud, not on your PC. If you want to ensure your data is backed up beyond Google's servers, make sure to export the documents periodically to your PC. Microsoft Office files are on your PC as long as they are either not within your OneDrive folder or they are within your OneDrive folder, but they are marked as always on this PC. Both cloud services have a recycle bin or a trash folder from which recently deleted files can be recovered. Microsoft's OneDrive also has this feature that notices when a large number of files have changed. This is intended to provide additional protection from large-scale accidental deletions or ransomware. And indeed, this feature requires a paid subscription of some sort. Google Docs is free with your Google account. There are paid Google Workspace accounts intended for business use, and those can include some additional Google Drive storage and some other features. And indeed, even without Google Workspace, you can still buy additional Google Drive space if you feel you need it, but the apps are completely free regardless. Microsoft 365 requires a paid subscription to use your traditional installable desktop applications. The subscription includes additional storage and other features. You can also share your subscription with up to 5 other Microsoft accounts, which independently get all of the same benefits. And free versions of the primary Office applications are available online within your Microsoft account. So, after all of that, what should you use? Well, first of all, if you're working with others in an organization, I strongly suggest you use whatever that organization uses to avoid compatibility issues and just to prevent confusion overall. That being said, I recommend you use Google Docs if you want something simple and free, you collaborate with others online a lot, you don't need advanced features and formatting, and you don't mind if your files are only in the cloud until you explicitly download them. On the other hand, I'd recommend you use Microsoft 365 if you need all of the features in the Microsoft applications, You regularly exchange documents with others using Microsoft 365 apps, and you prefer offline access and desktop applications. Bottom line here is that both tools are great depending on your needs. For casual users, Google Docs is probably plenty. For more advanced use, yeah, Microsoft 365 could easily be the way to go. One good approach, I would think, is to begin with the free version of Google Docs and just see how well it meets your needs. If you find yourself needing to switch, you can export and move your documents to the Microsoft toolset later. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/182833. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.